What's up everybody, this is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video. And this one folks, of 2022, is my second N scale or N gauge model train review. And today, this is a review of the Revolution Trains Class 92 electric locomotive N gauge 1 to 148 scale. Absolutely fantastic. I just gave this a wee test run just before doing this video to make sure it works, and I'll tell you something, it is super. Okay, without further ado, let's check the details. Reference number is N92008 as depicted on the box label as well. So there's your details folks, and this is the very first time I've actually done a review ever of the N scale class 92 electric locomotive. And I'll tell you something folks, nice amount of weight. It is considerably lighter than the class 60, and I've added a coupler to this already as it didn't come with one, and I've just installed an N scale magnetic coupler from Hunt's, of which is the magnetic ones. So without further ado, let's get this lid off and let's get to the contents then, shall we? Of course, this is the introduction, so I'm going to show you the model and we will have a look to see if it has any thing like traction tires and stuff. So I've never reviewed one of these before. I just put it on the track, just had a quick run on the line, so I want to make sure it's all working. As to be honest with you, there's nothing more disappointing than buying a model train only to test it and it doesn't run, you know. Beautiful, beautiful detail. I'm not sure if the camera is picking this up, but you'd see the separately separate, gosh, getting my tongue tied now, separately detailed parts all added all round. Wipers, air horns, front air dam detail. So, not sure if the camera is picking that up, but they are painted. This is 1 to 148 scale, so very, very nice detail all round. We do have the metal O-rings for the channel tunnel, which are attached to the sides. So these are separately fitted parts. Metal handrails all round. I believe this is made by Rapido Trains, if I'm not mistaken. And this paint, attention to the underside then, shall we? We do have the drive gears on the trucks, so that's all very well. And sadly, there is one traction tire here. So I think that is because this model is a bit lighter than the Farish Class 60 that I covered in the other review. And there's also another one there folks, so although it does have traction tires, so I just wanted to point that out to anybody that wants to get one of these models, just beware of this if you get one. Okay, but I'm not going to knock any points off, because at the end of the day, although traction tires is a bit of a double-edged subject really, so this is not about traction tires folks. This is about the model, and I'm not sure if the camera is picking this up, but we can see Rapido Trains and Revolution Trains, and there is a switch underneath. Model is DCC ready, and it uses the Next18 decoders, just to let you know. And what a fantastic model this is. Apologies for the cut in the video there folks, I just had to go off and do something, but where was we? Okay, what I was getting up to, I believe we were on to the separately fitted O-rings and other detail parts, and you can just see that British Rail logo, which is not made of metal, and this is N scale folks, full flush glazing all round, and we do have the adjustable pantographs, so you can raise these and have them at any height you want. I'm just showing this for demonstration purposes. As I do not have any catenary system, I will keep these in the down position just to avoid any damage in that. But just look at that detail, folks. I'm not sure if the camera is picking this up, as when I do the rotation and the close-ups, we may not see all of this, so I just want to make sure this is all on camera. And we are on the introduction, and you've got the air horns. These are all separately fitted as well. So what a cracking model. And this one is 92008 and is named as Jules Verne, which I believe is a composer for music or some kind of artist. But anyways, just want to put that out there, as I like to cover this model thoroughly. And I believe that there is a brush builder's plate, as these were built between 1994 and 1996, and three operators did have these: British Rail, European Passenger Services, and SNCF had some as well. And we've just turned the model around, got the same details on the sides, and just making sure that I've covered absolutely everything. And that, folks, if I'm not mistaken, I believe we have now covered the introduction. So the next thing for me to do is to have this model up on the turntable. Then we can do the close-ups, nice and close with the camera, and then the rotation, and then, of course, the performance test. Oopsie. It seems I forgot to cover something. And if we lift this tray off, you'll see what I mean. We actually do have the instructions and a packet of detail parts. So I'm going to quickly go through these. As you know, this one is a little bit hit and miss, but I will make sure I cover everything. This is just another magnetic coupler from Hunt's, and I will attach that to rolling stock, but I've used the other one with this Class 92. As you know, I'm not going to be using the default ones, as this only came with one coupler in the bag. So I'm just going to place that there. And you got some more traction tires, brake hoses, another air dam for the back, if you want to detail both ends. And of course, we'll quickly go through the instructions before we do the rotation. So apologies for not covering this earlier, but here is the instructions. This is information for DCC users and how to fit the decoder and stuff. The body just unclips, and here are all the details and stuff, like functions and that. Headlights, cab lights, and this model does have working cab lights, folks. And that's all the details and stuff. So that's the DCC leaflet covered. So it's two lots, and we'll place that down there so we don't lose them. This one is your general notes, and there's more information on this one, as it uses a Next18 DCC decoder. There is a sound version and warranty and troubleshooting and all that good stuff. Prototype details. So if you want to pause out and read that, if I can just get the light out of it, that is. So there we are. There's all your details, folks. So feel free to pause that if you want to. And on the other side, parts and the train in expanded view. As you know, I have to be careful what words we use on YouTube. So that's why I'm saying expanded. Okay. But that's all the paperwork and that done. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to place that all down there. And the next thing for us to do is to do the close-ups, then the rotation, and we will do a performance test. But honestly, folks, because I have no rolling stock fitted with magnet couplers yet, this will be a light engine run, okay? But the Class 60 from the last review will be the background train. It's now time to commence on with the close-ups. And without further ado, let's unlock this tripod and horn on the front. As you can see there, separately fitted air horns. Just allow my camera to refocus, as although this is N scale, my camera sometimes goes a bit crazy if I zoom in too close. Very nice front buffer beam detail, and I believe this is cab number one, hence the sharp fin aerial on this side. Pantographs, fully posable. Various catenary equipment, so we can cover that nice and closely. That's what I do love about these N scale models. This one is extensively detailed for its size. Various separately fitted parts, that's why these models are not the cheapest. Separately fitted pantographs and third rail conductor rail shoe pickup. Very nicely picked out on the trucks and panning across. The O-rings, or the channel tunnel rings that I call them, they are separately fitted parts along with the British Rail double arrows, 92008, complete with 00008 on the front. The older style catenary danger signs of the overhead cables, the square buffers, and plenty of detail to boot. So you do get a lot of value and a lot of detail for your money. But before this model came around, the only way you could get a Class 92 in N scale was for the ultra rare CJM models, and they didn't have working headlights or anything like that. As well, this one has working head, tail and cab lights, and it is a very nice model from Revolution Trains, in my opinion. Okay folks, that is the close-ups done. So the next thing for us to do is to move on to the full rotation. It's now time to commence with the full rotation. So let's zoom out. Just zoom out nice and slowly, making sure there's enough room for us to cover the train, and we will go clockwise, as I want to make sure I get everything covered, as I like to cover both sides of these models. And this is a very nice model, and you will see one of the magnet couplers on this end, as I do intend to fit magnetic couplers to all of my rolling stock that I plan to have in the future. So that will come in a later video. So definitely am pleased that I made the switch to N scale, and I'm looking forward to becoming a life coach in November. Well, launching my business, because I'm a fully accredited life coach, but the real work will come when I'm helping clients improve their lives, and I will cover more of that on my other channel. So anyways, sticking on topic, that is the close-ups and the rotation done. So the next thing for us to do now, folks, is to give this beautiful model train a test run. Under the performance test. It's time to have some fun now, folks, don't you think? Are you ready? Okay, without further ado, let's set up the background train, of which will be 60096 with the tankers. As the reasons I mentioned earlier in this video, I have no rolling stock with magnetic couplers as of yet, so this will just be a light engine run for the Class 92. So let's get the background train running. That will be the Class 60. And I'm using default settings here, folks, so you'll see the cab lights, the headlights and the tail lights, and also there's no train to worry about, as this is light engine running. You will see the Class 92's tail lights with no obstructions. So let's get that running then, shall we, folks? So let's just turn this on and let's get this train running. I want you to pay attention to the brightness. I've got it on 50% power, so I want you to pay attention to the brightness of the headlights and the cab lights, okay? And come to your own conclusions of what you feel about these N scale Class 92s from Revolution Trains. Personally, I think they are fantastic value for money. I do like the fact that there is working cab lights, as you don't see that on many N-scale model trains. The detail is absolutely fantastic. I'm not going to lie, folks, it really is. And one of these Class 92s, perhaps with some ferry van wagons or some intermodal container wagons, would look really grand on your model railway. As you know, I'm not supported or financed by any model train company. These reviews are all done out of my own pocket, because therefore that allows me to be honest and truthful with all of you, because I'm a strong believer in being honest with my audience, be it doing these unofficial reviews or being a coach with my clients, which is what my future career will be, you know. So I like to be candid, I like to be straight to the point. And one thing I didn't mention, although you may have noticed it in the close-ups, there is a driver's visor in the cab. So that looks really, really cool. And Rapido Trains and Revolution Trains has done a grand job on these models. And I do hope that they will do many more versions in the future, because to be honest, as much as I liked N-scale back in 2009-2011, I wasn't prepared to pay upwards of £500 for a CJN model. Not when, especially now, the Revolution Trains has now done a much superior, better detailed model with more functions, as this has working lights and stuff, including cab lights, and that's absolutely brilliant. Or at least it is, in my opinion, anyway, folks. Okay, I'm going to allow 2 more passes. Excuse me, I'm not sure what's wrong with my voice tonight. Probably the pollen count's a bit high, because I do suffer from winter hay fever, okay, but as I was saying, we'll do 1 more pass after this, and then we will switch to another angle to show you the tail lights, as we have seen the cab lights and the headlights for long enough. Okay, whilst we will get a frontal view of 6096 as a background train, I'm hoping that you can see the tail lights on this Class 92 from Rapido Trains Revolution Trains. For me, they're not too bright. I hope they're not too dull that the camera is ignoring them, but the ambience is quite acceptable. They're not overkill on the brightness, as you can just see there, but they're not too dull either. They look more natural, although I'm not sure what the Acura scale Class 92s will be like, and I don't plan to get one, because I no longer cover 00 gauge. I cover N scale now. So that's one of the reasons why I also cancelled my pre-order, because I thought if I switched to N scale, I can work and live anywhere in the world and still enjoy my hobby, okay? But anyway, it's a very nice model. What I will do, I'll have about 1 to 2 more passes, and then I will switch back to the default view, and then start winding down this review. In all honesty, I can't knock any points off this model, as the quality is there. It is running really well. This is exactly 50% par. The only detraction, which is kind of discretionary really, and I think the reason it has traction tires is because it is quite lightweight. So That boosts traction when it comes to pulling long trains and when going uphill. So that gives it the advantage. Although it would have been nice if they made the model a bit more heavier, but again, it's not a deal breaker, and you can always add more weight to the model, such as liquid gravity or that kind of thing, if you want to make the model more heavier to boost the traction, as that could be a good workaround if you want to remove the traction tires. But really, it's not a deal breaker, or at least for me. Anyway folks, one more pass and I think it's time to start winding down, okay? So one more pass, after this one, we'll start reeling it in. Okay, it's time to start breaking down the review in terms of the four sections. Quality, 5 out of 5. It's a very nice silent runner. In fact, most of the noise is coming from the background train. The Rapido Trains, Revolution Trains, Class 92 is almost silent running. Very, very smooth. Extensive amounts of detail. And it is probably one of the most detailed models I have in my collection at the moment. And I'm going to have a maximum of 10 model trains. But I've got some more gems to come, folks. I'm not ruining any surprises. So, anything you may have missed or not seen in the preview, when I did my channel announcement, well, the updates, then, which was about probably a week or two ago now, by the time this video goes up. So, that's in the video library somewhere. I do have a few more gems to come. And these are mostly my favourite trains. I do like the Class 92s. I do like the Class 60s. And there is a few other trains that I do like. From the UK and Europe, of course. And when I do move to the US to live and work, which is one of my plans, I will have a lot of N-scale US model trains as well. But whilst I'm portable, at least I can carry this little lot with me. It won't take too much space in the luggage, unlike HO scale and 00 gauge. And I think 10 N scale model trains is more than enough to give me entertainment. And I do plan to do some model train running sessions, but it will come after a few more reviews, okay? Anyways, let's start rounding this review off then. I'm really enjoying this one, even though the pollen is a bit high today because I do suffer from winter hay fever. I keep going no matter what. You know me, Scorpio rising here folks, so I just keep going. That's just me. Okay, let's break it down then. Performance, I'm going to give out a 5 out of 5. Features, 5 out of 5. Price, for what you get, factoring all the features we've covered, 5 out of 5, that's for the price. Performance, quality, 5 out of 5. So, it's all there to see. Detail, 4 out of 5. That rounds it off with a perfect 10 out of 10, folks. And that, my friends, concludes this review of the Revolution Trains, Rapido Trains, Class 92 electric locomotive, of which these were built between 1994 and 1996 for channel tunnel work. Although they can be seen, although they can be seen on the Caledonian sleepers, as GB Rail Freight do use them. So a number of the class can be seen on those workings, as well as freight on the West Coast Main Line, mostly with GDRS night. And, well, that concludes the video. I just want to say, big thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless. And I will catch you in another review coming soon. Okay? Cheerio, folks. All the best. And see you in the next one.
All I